All right, we're back for round two. This time I'm on the play. Ooh, not a very good hand. Again, I'm always tempted to keep when I see scry lands, but this is a bad hand to keep. A little bit better, and given that I'm now on six cards, definitely gonna be keeping this. Wonder why a chat box didn't pop up, but that's fine. Looking for accelerator or courser. I don't have double green yet. Although courser is the type of card I'm looking for, and it goes well with Domri. That's interesting. Think I kind of want to top that, strange as it sounds. There we go. Probably a black green devotion deck, although it could be black devotion splashing green or green devotion splashing black. Both are reasonably popular decks. All right, so we both top our scry. Aha, it is green devotion. Well, if he plays another creature, that makes things a little awkward for my Domri. If he plays Voyaging Satyr or Sylvan Caryatid, then I'll just play Domri anyway. Another Burning Tree. Now I can't play Domri, so I hope I draw a forest. Whoa, Brush Strider. So this is like an aggro green aspect of the Hydra deck, maybe. Interesting. I think it's better to do nothing this turn, although I'm probably going to lose this game. I could see playing Domri and plussing just because it very marginally increases the chances that I'll draw a land next turn. Because the chances of me drawing a land next turn right now are the chances of my top card being a land. But if I played Domri and plussed, then the chances of me drawing a land next turn would be the chances of my top card being a land plus the chances of my top card being a creature and my second card down being a land. But pretty marginal, and I'd rather just keep a Domri for future use. Only have five lands in my deck that don't add green mana, and I've drawn three of them. It's a little unusual. Yeah. Am I just straight up dead? I guess I can be at one life. I'll just choose not to reveal any cards so he doesn't know exactly what I'm playing. Mean, I guess he kind of knows, but maybe not. Aha, main decks, tests, and tactics. So I learned something useful. Well, a bit of a non-game there, but you would expect the bigger version of Green Devotion would be an advantage against the smaller version of Green Devotion. Mortar's coming in. Nylia's Disciples coming in. Cetacean Tactics, Scavenging Ooze. Let's think about the Chandra for a second. I did see Brush Strider. I have to imagine Elvish Mystic. Unclear whether or not it's worth bringing in. Let's see what I have to take out. Garrick, I could see being a little slow. Yeah, usually against these aggro decks, I go to boarding out my Planeswalkers. You saw me board out Nylea in previous games, but the Green Devotion deck doesn't kill any of my creatures, so it's a little bit easier to activate it, and then it just brick walls them. So, what else could I cut? I guess I'm not going to bring in the Chandras. I think this is probably the best configuration.